Welcome back, everybody. Another week, another episode. Hearthstone Power Hour coming directly at you. Welcome to the show, however it is that you're watching this. Whether you're watching it on iTunes or YouTube or the numerous other ways that I'm forgetting right now of watching this show. I'm glad that you're watching it. I'm glad that you're here. I'm your host, Twiz. So good to meet you guys. So good to see ya. Let me break down the show for you in case you're watching this for the very first time, okay? We take a deck and feature it every week. We give you a deck breakdown. We play some games with it. We talk about some of the moves, some of the you know, better moves, some of the not so better moves, how to play around things and stuff like that. I play the role of Average Joe, okay? I'm doing a little bit better, but I'm okay. It's the person behind the scenes that's not so behind the scenes, the magic maker, if you will. That would be the legendary, my co-host, Mr. Sexy Setter himself. Good evening, sir.
How is everyone doing?
We've got to come up with a new intro line for you.
I got nothing. Dude, the problem is, like, it's Monday, so, like, I'm just going to say it's Monday next time. Just, it's Monday, Twiz.
It's Monday, Twiz. It's Monday. Absolutely. So, well, anyways, dude, it's good to have you. Good to have you back on the show. Like, we're coming up, dude, we're coming up on 50 episodes. Can you believe that? On March 10th, that'll be our birthday, dude. 1 year we've been doing this.
Oh, boy. Oh, boy.
Tension mounts. Oh, what a feeling.
Or should we celebrate?
I think we should do it. I think we should do the show with our shirts off. What do you think?
All right. Okay. All right.
Maybe not.
I think we should have all of the fans send us $5 each. Okay. Oh, that doesn't work, right? That's bad. Sorry.
We'll go straight for the monetary value. So, anyways, guys, jam-packed episode this week for you. Good stuff. Couple of things real quick. In case you didn't notice for some reason, and you've watched this show in the past, the Twizcast studio, the Power Hour studio, has gone under some changes, and Mrs. Twiz has said that we're going to be, making some changes and moving some things around. So, anyways, there's more to things are gonna change as the weeks carry on. So, anyways, that's why that looks a little different. I'm not really super big fan of the setup and how to run everything, but I'm making it work. So, anyways, yeah. Enough of the crap.
He's still gotta get that framed naked picture going up behind him.
That's
guys,
right.
Don't worry, that's coming back.
That's right. A Balrog fan. Yes, it's coming back. Absolutely. So, anyways, but you know what? Him and Review Dad Media in that embrace is just, it's so heartwarming. I can't not have it here in the office. But anyways, how's the ladder treating you, dude? We're down to the last 5 days here.
I honestly, like, I don't play that much.
Really?
This past week, like, I got to 5 this season, and I'm just like, I'll do it.
Yeah.
And I kind of moseyed down to 4 and moseyed back up to 5. And it's like, eventually I'll just tough it out and I'll do it. But I just like, oh, man. Oh.
Remind me after the show's over with to never give that answer again.
Why? I'll mosey up to Legend. I have to sit down and do it, man.
I hear you. Dude, last night I ran into a string of bad cards that you freaking read about, man. Like, it was about an hour and a half, and I successfully lost 2 ranks. I got beat by Undertaker Druid. I didn't even know it was a thing. I didn't know Undertaker Druid was the thing, but it is, and they beat me. As a matter of fact, the killing blow came from a novice engineer. I put it all together, and it was like, bam, 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 novice engineer. Excuse me? And it happened. So, anyways. But no, I was playing, like, Snuggles. The deck we featured last week. And I was getting, like, no wild pyros. Or I had both of them, but I had no triggers for any of them. You know, I didn't even have the stinking coin. It just stuff like that, man. Like, bad opening hands left and right. And, oh, it was just a nightmare. Ramp Druid I'm glad that finally on turn 13 I saw Wild Growth, you know. So, anyways, but last night I drowned my sorrows in the bottom of a bottle, and that was that. So, But let's talk a little bit about the deck we have this week. And I have to say, this is a very fun deck. It's very bursty. And it's a little bit controlly. I mean, Rogue is very controlly, kind of, to a point, but still bursty, if that makes any sense whatsoever. Like, controlly in that, against most other aggro decks, like back in the day, Miracle, just, it really pooped on Zoo. And this is still kind of the same way. It really keeps the aggro decks in check. So why don't we break it down, Stutter? Well, let's talk about what we have going on here.
Oh, we got two backstabs, because it's Rogue.
And it's trigger card. Preps.
Yeah, we got two preps. Prepper is actually less of a card draw card like it used to be used in with Gedgesan. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna put my feet up, guys. Feet's going up. But now it's more of a tempo play card, so you can kind of like play a minion, prep, eviscerate.
Mm-hmm. Use it for its actual minion, prep, intention.
Use any spell, and then kind of like just have the board, you know. Get that board really early on. Make them fight back for board position. You got Deadly Poisons because it's, again, Rogue guys. We got Celsi Deckhands, two of them, because these kind of like allow for a burst of Tinkers.
With
Sharp Wood Oil.
Sharp Sword. Sharp Wood.
Yeah, Sharp Wood guys.
Stutter's very familiar with this deck, guys. Very.
Well, I'm actually not familiar with the card. I don't know what it's called is my issue. I know it's Tinkmaster that's not Tinkmaster. No. Like, that's the card I know it as. It's like, oh, it's the Tinkmaster that doesn't turn something into a 5/5 thing against you.
Yeah. Sorry, yeah. I glanced over
that's
it.
That's what I know that card as.
But basically, yeah, that's what it does is it's a trigger card. On turn 5, you can South Sea Deckhand... assuming you daggered up on turn 4 or previously, and then Tinker Sharp Sword Oil, and that's going to give you a 4 damage weapon and a 5 damage South Sea Deckhand.
Yep. And it also obviously combos with Blade Flurry. That's why there's two Blade Flurries in the deck, because you got two Deadly Poisons, you got two Tink Master Sharp Wood Oils.
Sharp.
It's happening, guys. It's happening. We got... two Eviscerates, because it's Rogue. Two Saps. This is basically to keep all those big minions in check. Like, sapping Ancient of War. Huge. Sapping oh my god, what's that? 6/5 Savannah High Main.
Yeah.
That's just... you win the game, then, if you can do that. You got one Shiv for card draw, pretty much. And plus, you can do the prep thing. And also, you have spell damage boost with Blood Mage, as well as Zerdrake, so Shiv can be actually really useful if you get, like, a prep. Like, a Zerdrake prep Shiv is actually a very valued card. Like, it's a valued combo. You got Phantom Knives, two of them, because if you, again, you got some spell power on the board, it's a board clear.
Yep.
And it also gives you a card. And there's so many 1/1 tokens running around that it's just so much more value these days than it used to have.
Oh, absolutely.
We got one Earthrend Farseer for a turn 3 play, as well as healing.
Just to piggyback on that a little bit, again, you have to have the cards in your hand, but turn 7, Azure Drake, Blood Mage Thalnos, Prep, Fan of Knives, there goes all that quartermaster mustard for battle nonsense. So it's really easy to boost up the spell power on this stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So, sorry. Anyways, Earthrend Farseers.
Yeah, right. Just one Earthrend Farseer just for turn 3 play that you don't have to combo out. And just restores 3 health, because all aggro, you kind of need health. We got two SI7 agents, because, again, SI7s are just like, it's one of those cards where you can really get the board back. Because you can do, you can use it as you clear a minion, and you get a 3/3 body. I mean, I love this card. I think it's one of the most underrated cards in the game. So good. We got two Tinkmaster Sharp Wood Oils.
Tinkmaster's Woody Oil, yep.
Yeah. We already talked about that. We got a Gnomish Inventor, 2/4. It's kind of a sticky minion plus a card draw. And sticky minions are like the name of the game these days because you just want minions that don't really die. We got a antique heal bot. I mean, it's just card or it's not card draw. It's just heal.
It's just heal. 3/3 body and if you're getting mowed down pretty, you know, it's
every ego player hates that card.
Yeah,
they just hate it because it just gives them so much health. We got an two Azure Drakes because a 4/4 body for 5 plus card draw and spell damage. It's like it's the made for rogue 5 drop really.
Mm-hmm.
We got a Lotheb because Lotheb's awesome, 5/5 for 5, and its battle cry is just amazing.
Mm-hmm.
Then we got a Trade Prince Gallywinks because it's awesome as well. A 5/8 for 6 is just value on its own, and its ability is incredible.
Yeah, and you know what? It's so funny. Like, you would not believe, if you're thinking about crafting one and you don't know what to craft, if you get him, he's worth his weight. Because, like, I played this deck versus a hunter earlier this week, and, like, people just don't read the text. Like, they're just like, yeah, it's a 5/8, and he probably does something, whatever. And he gave me a snake trap. Like, I had Gallywinks on the board, and he plays snake trap, and then snake trap lands in my hand. It's like, thanks, dude. All right. And then he kill commanded something else. And so by the time it was over with, like, I was able to, I don't know, I hit him with some minions and then I eviscerated and then I killed him with his own stinking kill command. How's that feel? So this guy, he's a nuisance. There's no doubt about it. And sprint is simply just card draw. A good combination a lot of people don't really think about is if you're really kind of sitting on a, you know, cards that are, they're good but not in conjunction and they're not helping you, prep sprint. That's a 4 cost, the 4 mana for 4 cards. I mean, there's value in prep sprint all day long. So, yeah. Anything else?
So some people were asking how to replace Prince Gallywinks. Trade Prince Gallywinks, first off, I think is one of the best legendaries released in this expansion. I've been saying that since day one. He's just pure swag. But if you don't have him, he's a lot of fun to play.
Mm-hmm.
And if you're looking for fun, I would suggest crafting him. If not, I would play, if you don't have him, though, play a sticky minion. Maybe play, it's possible to do a Sunwalker, maybe? Maybe, I mean, there's a lot of 6 drops, but I would suggest, yeah, let's go to 6 drops. I would suggest Sunwalker, probably, if you have that.
Cairn's not bad.
It's fun. You could use a, you could possibly use a piloted Sky Golem isn't bad, and Illidan, mm-hmm. if you have that. You could do,
Mogor, if you have Mogor. I mean,
yeah,
that's a 7/6, and all minions have a 50% chance to attack the wrong enemy. I mean, that can be problematic on both sides, but... Or Sylvanas.
Yeah, Sylvanas is also really good. Just stuff that's a pain in the butt to deal with. So if you don't have any of those legendary... First off, I think Sylvanas is probably the best. Piloted Sky Golem also works really well. Heck, you can even throw in a Hogger if you want that. That's
Sylvanas,
pure swag.
Sylvanas would be pretty sweet, again, because... If they ignore her, you can Blood Mage Thalnos, eviscerate her, and take one of their minions. You know, so you play. Yeah, that's pretty much all I'm thinking. You can. It's like fireballing Sylvanas as a mage. So, if you have the ability to do 5 damage to her, you can. Yeah. So.
Exactly. Yeah, yeah.
But we'll see how this pans out. A couple of substitutions that I thought you could probably go kind of without, depending on what you're seeing. Maybe swapping something out for another Shiv. Swapping something out for another Earthen Ring, or I don't like the Gnomish Inventor, although it saved my bacon twice in the last 2 games. So I still
the thing is that The Gnomish Inventor is there because it's a 4 drop. You can just throw it on in 4 if you don't have the board. You can just, boom, throw it down, and it trades decently well with the type of meta you're seeing these days.
Yeah. Well, here's the thing, guys. I think this could be a really exciting episode, or this could be, like, total crap, because it's the last 5 days of the ladder, so it is, like, aggro, 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 garbage, garbage, garbage. But, I mean, Undertaker Druid. Who would have thought that was coming out of the pipe, you know what I mean? So, we might see some interesting decks here. Cue it up, shall we? Shall we? Let's do it. Let's do it. Let's do it. It's so weird having to turn around to see the chat room like this. I don't know that I like that. I'm going to have to work on it. We're going to have to see. So, for those of you who are curious, tomorrow night is the Heroes Power Hour, where we feature Heroes of the Storm. And we've got some beta keys, boys, to give away. All right, we've got EU and NA beta keys.
Twiz is already guaranteed to give me 5. Just for my own use, guys. Just get rid of it all. I would maybe keep Blade Flurry. Actually, keep Blade Flurry. get rid of Prep. Yeah, it hurts, but I think we want to get rid of Prep. I'm just kidding, by the way. They're not going to give me any big keys.
No, they're not
going to
give you any.
All right. End turn, yeah.
I think versus Handlock, Sap is going to be your friend, but...
I think you just dagger up and hit that.
Yeah.
I know it sucks, but...
Well, at the end of the day, we do have an Earthen Ring Farseer and a Healbot in here.
Mm-hmm.
And they are the last two cards at the bottom of the deck, just so you guys know.
I kind of like sapping the 3-2 Flame Imp.
Mm-hmm.
And then running a Celsi Deckhands into
the other 3-2?
Yeah.
Yeah, me too.
I think we should do that.
Let's do that. It's not ideal, but...
Don't attack face. Yeah. But this allows him... Basically, he has to have a turn 3 play. It throws him off his curve is the idea. He'll end up playing that anyways, but... Whatever he plays next turn, our Gnomish Inventor will probably take care of it. Yeah, just play Gnomish Inventor. And just don't do anything else.
Okay.
There we go. Easy peasy. Don't backstab it. It's just a really good card to have because like it takes care of a lot of stuff, especially in Zoo. Prep is looking like a great card next turn.
That's what I'm screaming, dude. That is precisely what I'm thinking.
Of course, if he doesn't do...
Oh, man, look at that. Guess who forgot to silence their cell phone? That'd be me.
We can clear the board. I kind of like that. Let's clear the board.
Okay.
Attacking the 2-3, no, the 2-4 into the
3-1.
The 2-3. Yeah. Oh, no.
Gnomish Inventor into the
2-3 Harvest Golem.
Yeah, okay.
I'm going to use my words. I'm going to use my English words. Fan of Knives. then Blade Flurry.
Yeah. Yeah.
But, like, the idea against Zoo is you can just keep him tapping, and, like, we have an easy kill with Backstab, plus pretty much anything else. So, like, if he plays, like, a Doomguard, then we just Backstab Abyss and SI7. It kind of sucks, but it's life. Next turn, if he doesn't do much, we could just do, like, an Azure Drake and Backstab it. Like, he's clearly... He doesn't have anything. He's confused. He's confused as why he doesn't have a board.
DJ Tyrant just sent me... He's one of the guys on the Heroes Power Hour. He sent me a text message. He's like, silence your cell phone. Also, there's no in-game audio. Brother, there hasn't been in-game audio for like 44 episodes.
I'll play Sure Drake. and then just trade in that 2-2 with... Yep.
Oh, man. So anyways, like I was saying, we've got some Heroes beta keys, guys. We're going to be featuring Kerrigan, and we have... Holy snot. All right. Oh, this is going to be... This is going to be a big turn.
This is going to be a great turn.
This is going to be...
Dagger up.
Yep. We're going to backstab. We're going to...
Backstab.
Yeah. We're going to Sousy Deckhands. We're going to...
Yep.
Tinkmeister Woody Oil. Okay.
Yeah. There we go. The Tinkster.
Tinkmeister.
And then just go phase with both. And this is easy lethal next turn.
Yep. We got 4, 8...
Bleed Flurry, yeah, that's right. So even if he plays a taunt.
Yep.
Unless he's got swag heals in this game, or in this deck.
He might. Oh, Mortal Coil.
Foiled.
Foiled again. Yeah, Blade Flurry, Eviscerate.
Yep. Easy peasy lemon squeezy.
Yep. Oh, he's gonna taunt up.
Oh, dude, he's got swag.
Swag.
The taunting dummy. Oh. We can do so much damage.
I know. Just we can do so much BM.
I know. Just kill him.
Yeah. So bursty. So
we
bursty.
We even had an extra damage right there.
Yeah. Yep. Exactly. Alrighty. So
I got respect for anyone who plays targeting dummy.
That's true. that's true, dude. That's true. Targeting dummy for the win. Everybody, even chat. We've got Nathan9125 joining us from Australia in the chat room. Good to see you, brother.
Boy.
Good to see you.
I'm getting old, Twiz.
I know, dude. Priest. I don't know how this does against Priest.
I would keep Backstab, Blood. I would keep almost this whole hand.
Yeah, I would too, because you can combo Backstab with SI7. That gives
combo.
You card draw. You could combo it. Three damage. Yep. Yeah. Let's do that.
Just, yeah, in turn.
So, yeah, we're going to be giving out... Oh, I see we got Mubot going. We're going to be giving out 10 NA keys and 10 EU keys. Blood Mage Thalnos, Backstab, all day long.
Yep. Easy. Easy out.
Do-do-do-do-do-do-do.
I kind of like just daggering up here.
Yeah. I mean, I want to kind of get the body on the board, but at the same time, I want to get a dagger in my hand, too.
Yeah, I think we just want to get dagger in our hand.
All right.
And you can just go face the one and just leave the dagger.
Yeah. It's kind of what I'm thinking. Chat room, you guys are knocking out of the park tonight.
I don't even know what the other play would have been.
Let's see here. Okay. Four.
I'll just play
Gnomish Inventor.
Yep. Yep.
Okay.
Yep. Just end turn. Here's what I want to do.
If we coin oil, shiv that. I don't know. I don't know if that's such a great idea.
I'm thinking. I think we can we clear board here.
We're gonna have to choose quick.
All right. Coin double SI
on the 3/5.
The 3/5. Yep. Clear the last little bit with your face, and then face.
Yeah. Come on. Blizzard, you and your rotten damn spell effects. Don't give a crap about that. When I lose 2.5 seconds...
It's all the sludge belcher is the problem. The sludge belcher takes forever.
Whatever.
Yeah. Worst things have happened, though, you know?
I know, but that's just annoying. It's just annoying.
Can we clear board?
Four, five. We have to give up a South Sea deckhand to do it.
And we have to give up our SS7 agent.
Yeah.
I don't really like that.
Yeah, me neither.
Can we shiv the 1/2? No, shiv the 3/1. Shiv the 3/1. Yeah, shiv the 3/1.
Great. That's exactly what we wanted.
Earthring Farseer yourself. And clear the 1/2 with your 3/3.
Yeah.
Man, that cabal screwed us. And I kind of knew that was coming, but I was like, we can't really play around it.
Yeah. Well, what else do we have?
Why?
I think a cabal then.
Why do people play Shadow War Pain anymore, guys? I don't understand it.
It's apparently a thing.
Man, I kind of want to just like.
2, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Yeah, it's not enough mana. I kind of just want to sprint. Oh, this is such a bad place.
Yeah.
Oh.
Well, so at the end of the day, we can eviscerate and blade flurry once we get the sharp sword oil on, and that's going to take care of that 4-8.
But so much, and like we're going to take so much damage in the meantime, as well as just going to build a huge board. Like, how are we going to do this in one turn? Sprint for preps. If we get preps, we're in a good spot.
Not a one.
All right. We're going to burn a card, but it's fine.
Yeah.
Just end turn.
This is rogue life. Having... having this many cards in one hand. We're going to burn a prep. You watch and see if it doesn't happen. We're going to burn a prep. Oh, the fan of knives.
Eh, we're dead.
Yeah.
You can just go. There's no way you can get out of this. So, you sap the 7-7. He's going to play it next turn anyways. Then when you leave the 4-8 up and you blade flip... or you have Phantom Knives right now, and you take the bombs to the face.
We gotta do. Let's try something. Let's just see what happens.
Okay, let's play Phantom Knives.
Yep. And then we're gonna sap.
No, sap the 7-6. Redagger and deadly poison. We're gonna die next turn though, because he's gonna replay that, and we're gonna bomb, so we can't clear him.
Yeah. Yep. Not even worth screwing around with. That was just crap. Crap hand all the way around. Can you believe we were down to, 10 cards in our deck and we didn't get one prep?
If we got... we needed one prep the entire game.
Yeah. Man.
Did we mulligan a prep? No, we didn't. We didn't mulligan anything that game.
Yeah, we kept all of it.
We mulliganed the prep the game before.
Yep. Oh, weird. A hunter. I didn't know I would face.
I'm surprised we haven't played 300s in a row.
I know, right?
I kind of like keeping up prep and Phantom Knives in here. Shiv, I would keep everything.
Yeah.
It's weird, but I think this is a really good hand.
Hmm.
Because the idea behind Hunter is just running him out of cards.
So glad we didn't get a backstab, because that would suck.
End turn. Dagger up. Dagger up, coin deadly poison. Yep. Kill the 2-3.
Yeah.
That sucks. I hate Undertaker starts. Undertaker is one of the most overpowered cards in this game. I kind of want to hit that and then just Phantom Knives. With her face.
Yeah.
I think we have to.
Yeah.
Great. Sprint's really going to help us in this game.
It will. Prep sprint next turn.
Yeah. With no board presence.
We're going to draw a backstab. We're going to prep We're going to backstab that 3-2. Or not.
Oh, we're just going to Blood Mage and then Shiv it. Shiv. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Oh my god, this guy is such a good draw!
Mm-hmm.
Dagger up. Hit. Go for face with the 1-1. Actually, no. Go for the 3-1 with the 1-1. Play CLC deck hands. Prep. The oil.
Mm-hmm. Face.
And I kind of clearing that with your face, and then going face with the 5-1.
Yeah, that's pretty much what I'm thinking.
Oh my god, this guy's so greedy.
Wow.
I would just play,
Should I Blood Mage Thalnos? Because that's explosive trap all day long.
You think?
I think it is.
We can test for the trap this turn if we want to. We could test for it next turn as well. We could hit face with our face, I assuming it's freezing trap again.
You want me to do that?
Oh man, this is so tough. If that's freezing trap, we lose. Or if that's explosive trap, we lose.
How about we just backstab?
I say we just play out our. Oh my god, what? Gnomish Inventor? Yep.
Blade Flurry?
I'll backstab it. That's it. Just end turn.
Okay.
We have to draw a heal bot.
Yeah.
One of those is certainly explosive.
Yeah.
Sprint. And just end turn. We don't have to do anything.
Three, four, five. Does he have double kill command?
I hate people who, like, oh my god, I just...
Yeah, and he gives me the whole, I will hunt you down taunt.
Yeah. Like, dude, relax, you had the nut draw. You had the dream start.
Yeah, yeah. And you play Hunter, which kind of means that you have, like, a lot of time on your hands and the average reading level of a second grader.
It's just... Bugs me when people like emote like all the time when it's like, dude, you went Undertaker into
Loot Hoarder.
Hoarder, and then you went turn 3 Animal Companion, turn 4 Animal Companion.
Yeah. Dude, we were outplayed. We were outplayed the entire game. Bottom line.
Well, I mean, he just played what he did. He didn't do anything special. You shouldn't emote for that. Just keep death or deadly poison and get rid of the rest.
He mulliganed 2 out of 3.
Yeah, I would... Sap doesn't do much in the beginning against Handlock.
Well, in the beginning, a turn 4 is either an 8-8 or a 4-9.
Yeah, but then he just plays it the next turn, and you still don't have board.
Okay, so keep what and get rid of what?
Keep Deadly Poison, get rid of the rest.
Yeah, and outside of Blood Mage Thalnos, there's really no, like, early minions.
Yeah.
Great.
What a surprise. End turn. Dagger up.
Should I coin Deadly Poison?
Nope.
We don't want to get rid of that?
He didn't play. He didn't have anything to buff it last turn. He's not going to have anything to buff it this turn.
Okay. You heard it here, folks.
And if he does, we just Deadly Poison Blade Flurry.
Oh, yeah, didn't have anything. There's no reason to take it out before. So now we can take 4 damage instead of 2 damage.
Don't be salty, Twist. Deadly Poison, we take
could,
it out.
We could Deadly Poison, go face, Blade Flurry.
No, we're going to Blade Flurry later on. He's going to overload the board this next turn. Deadly Poison, take out the 2-3.
Okay. That's it.
Like, he had to draw into that. Yep. I kind of want a Gnomish Inventor.
I kind of want to Eviscerate that.
Well, how are you going to combo the Eviscerate?
With a coin?
I think we Gnomish Inventor. And the reason I say this is because this is going to give a minion on the board. Next turn, we can either Blade Flurry the whole entire thing when he attacks that, or we just let it go. Like, I'm fine with taking this damage. Zoo has little to no burst. I don't know if you've noticed that.
Yeah, I noticed it now.
Just sap it. He just wasted a card. Sap. Coin. Oil. And go face with the 5-4. Keep the 6-1.
Siron in the chat room's like, Twist is kind of silly today. Holy F. They're watching the plays. It's hilarious.
You have a lethal, I think. Wait, so you have 2 plus 3 is 5 plus. Earth Ring Farseer yourself. Eviscerate the 3-2.
Yeah.
And I think you just sit.
Yeah, sit. Because next turn...
Yeah, I mean, you could play Stealthy Deck and put in 2 damage. But I don't want him wiping the board for some weird reason because he's playing some janky deck.
Hellfire or something like that. Don't you taunt. Oh, man, the Void Terror. 6, 7, 8, 9. That's 5, 3. That's 5.
Just a Zhurdrake and Blade Flurry. You don't have lethal.
Okay.
This is a fine turn.
Okay.
You win.
Yep.
There you go. Sharp wood oil never fails us. It's true, guys.
Tink Masters Woody.
It's true.
Yeah. So it's so weird seeing nothing but aggro right now. Just can't. But the games are quick. The games are quick. And I can tell you, like, more than anything, that particular win, ladies and gentlemen, brought to you by The Haw. That's right. Not affiliated with the show whatsoever. We don't get any kickbacks from this. They probably don't even know that we do it. And frankly, I'm okay with that. But it tastes like complete and total garbage. You don't want it. You don't want it. Like, there are hazardous waste plants that will reject this. I guarantee you. So, next time Captain Greed sits on the other side of the board from you, smacks you with a 10-6, and you come back and just wipe his nose for him, crack open a can of hee-haw, chug it, and kick the hell out of something. Mandatory. Make it rain. Key Doke. Let's do it again.
Worst bet, making it rain. If it rained hee-haw, it'd be terrible. Nobody would go outside.
DJ Tyron, don't you dare take Balrog Fan out of my chat room to play Heroes. Don't you dare. Sorry. The little bit that I do get to see chat, I feel like I need binoculars. It's way over there. What do you think, Hunter or Warlock?
Get it on your iPad.
Oh, Warlock. There we go. Actually, I got the Surface Pro 3.
Keep Bladefiller, get rid of the rest.
Yeah. I got the Surface Pro 3, and I can run Heroes on it. But I can't run Diablo, however that works.
You're getting assed? Assed. A-S-S-I-T. After the show, Twiz, apparently, by the way.
Oh, yeah. I see that, yes.
Why don't you just ship that? Just go ahead and ship it. Ship it away. Get it off my board.
I wasn't paying attention to anything you just said, but you did say shiv that, right?
Yeah.
Okay, because I just did that. That just happened. Well played. Thanks. I'm just using the cards that I put in my deck.
Just dagger it up. I wouldn't even do anything with the dagger.
Oh boy, oh boy. Keeps coming up as unknown for everybody that I play.
What? What?
Yeah.
What?
It happened.
I would backstab it.
Backstab it. Deadly poison, go face, Blade Flurry.
Why would you Blade Flurry? It's gonna be dead. No, don't go face. Take the 4 damage.
Oh, okay.
And then we can still see deck hands and go hit his face with it.
Do we want to do that, or do we want to save it for next time when we can combo it with the sharp sword?
We can rewind it right now.
Oh. Oh, yeah. I like that. That was greedy.
That's all right. It doesn't matter, because we have so many turns mapped out after this that that's a perfectly fine turn.
Yes, Albert Blaze, you are correct. I am not lying to you a bit. It runs Heroes on there. Yep. Yep.
How's your Drake? Just don't even attack that either. Oh man, we can make such a big Blade Flurry. Yeah, we're good. I was very curious. Is
5 days. 5 days, guys. Now, here's the thing, is that thing can backfire and hit that 2-1. So
no, it can't, because it's a mech.
Oh, that's right, it is a mech, isn't it? I'm sure everybody heard my clock going off just then.
We all did.
We all did, yep. So...
I wish we had one more mana.
I know.
We could just backstab Blade Flurry, re-dagger.
Yeah, I think that's the play.
Yeah, I kind of like that.
It sucks.
I almost want to re-dagger and just deadly poison up this next turn. In fact, I do want to just deadly poison up right now.
Okay.
Alright, and just end turn.
Okay. I'm going to go shut my closet door here, or my office door. Hang on a minute. I'm afraid Snuggles, my dog, is going to come in and start going to town on my leg or my microphone or who knows what. For those of you who don't know, we adopted a dog and he's a humper. No doubt.
No doubt. I would just sprint right now. Oh. Yep. Definitely sprint. And I would maybe just hit face with this thing.
I could hit that. I could hit that 2-3 and then prep Fan of Knives.
No, I kind of like just hitting face with this.
Okay.
Yeah. Yep.
Okay.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah, we gotta get rid of that 2-3. He's just wailing on it.
I would Lothep right now.
Okay.
And then sap the 4-3. Yep, sap it. And clear the 2-3 with your face. Mm-hmm.
Call it good? Yeah.
Yeah. I will literally sell my soul for the second Blade Flurry.
Mm-hmm.
It's on you takers, guys. It's not worth much. I can understand.
What?
Dagger up.
Wait a minute.
I think we have lethal. Dagger up. Celsi deckhand. Do the oil thing.
Eviscerate his face.
Nope, I think we prepped the second oil thing. Yep, do it. And just go face with both. Yep, do it. All right.
4, 8, 7. He needs to heal. Of course he's got it. Why wouldn't he?
Jesus Christ!
He just got freaking Wind Fury on the 6-4.
No, he got lethal is what he got. Wood Mage Selmos. Phantom Knives. Come on. How troll is that? Alright. Nothing we can do, guys.
We could eviscerate the 1-1 and hope for our Blade Flurry.
Wait a minute. Oh, man. If we had the SS7, we would have had lethal, I think. If we had like a billion mana, too, right now.
Yeah.
Wait a minute. Oh, my God. We're too short. Yeah, we didn't have lethal before either. Oh well.
I'm gonna go for the Blade Flurry. Nope. De pinche de no es bueno.
Oh my God.
What?
Oh no, we wouldn't have lethal. Okay. I'm
playing it out.
I was trying to figure out a way we had lethal. But we would have had a SS7 our own thing. We would have gotten prep. I don't know, man.
Yeah, that helps if you know what's coming. Helps if you know what's coming.
Yeah.
So, this deck is pretty... It's pretty popular on the ladder, but... I don't know if it's the fact that I don't play Rogue well, or I don't know. Rogue's okay. You know, you have some of those classes that you just grab onto and some of them that you don't. And so... I think getting rid of Blade Flurry and Anti-Keelbot is probably a good idea.
Yep.
You always keep Backstab as a trigger, obviously. Sap's good to have for the coin, innervate, innervate, coin, innervate, Ysera. Should I go for face or no?
Yeah, why not? Go for face.
See, the difference in playstyle between me and you is you're like, yeah, go for face. Now I have one more. Now I have one. So if I have a way to deadly poison to get rid of something or whatever, I've only got one charge on my dealio. I don't necessarily know that that's worth sapping.
He innervated it out.
Yeah.
I'm going to clear it.
Yeah, but what comes after that, I wonder.
And we'd have to use two cards.
But we know we backstab it, hit it with our face.
Yeah, and then something comes out and we Celsi deckhands it.
Unless it's like a Doomsayer.
Yeah, let's do that. Let's backstab and let's hit her with her face.
Do you think that's worth killing?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I do.
Yeah, because he's going to get too much value off of that. Off of that 4-3. He's going to get 7 total damage off of that. Too much value. Too much value. What is this?
I would Phantom Knives. No, just hit that.
God. We're going to kill ourselves against these minions. I think Azure Drake.
I'm thinking... Yeah, Azure Drake. It's fine. Well, that's good. That's such a greedy swipe. Unbelievable.
Well, probably, actually, probably play not trade. That bad of a play.
Play trade. Yep.
Probably not that bad of a trade because...
No, but it's really greedy.
We're down to 18 health because we smacked our face against 2 4-3s.
So yeah, we're going to get huge, huge... Azure Drake. Yep. Sap the 4-3. And then clear the 4-4 with the 5-8.
Okay, Mr. Healbot, you can show up anytime now. Holy snot.
Play Blood Mage, stun us. Shiv the 3-5. Phantom Knives.
Backstab that.
Clear with the fort. No, clear with the Celsi deckhand. Celsi deckhands. Yep. And go face with everything else. Including your face.
So he's got to...
No, come on!
Force Roar.
No, are you kidding me?!
Force Roar.
What a bullcrap game.
Unbelievable.
Whatever.
Totally believable. So here's one of the things, guys. I'm going to come right out and I'm going to say this. I hate this deck. I really hate it. It's no bueno. Don't play this. I mean, or if you do play it, don't play it when there's 5 days left in the season. It's...
I mean, that was just so... That was the perfect draw. I'm sorry, that was the perfect draw for a druid.
No, I think it's a weak deck, dude, because it's like, we can only sit and say... Because, I mean, like, our past four opponents have had the perfect draw. You know what I mean? Like,
the last two, really.
It's not really that they've had perfect draws. I think that this deck just needs more tweaking. I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know.
Maybe it works really good at, like, rank 4, 3, 2, or once you're into Legend or something like that, but
maybe
for this, not so
maybe
much.
Maybe just decent. I don't know. It was just like, but anytime you coin Force War for lethal, that's a really good draw. I mean, you had Innervate out to that. The only thing better would have been if he went second and he got the coin.
Yeah. Well, and we didn't help the case by daggering up and him getting so much value off of his early minions. I mean, by turn 5, we were down to like 18 health or something like that. So, that's the curse of playing a rogue. Or I mean, even like a pally or something like that. When you've got a weapon, or a warrior especially, you've got a weapon that can do some damage, you'll wear yourself out against the minions just trying to keep board control. That's why Gore Howl sucks, in my opinion. That's
why Rogue in general is kind of these days. It's like you just hit your face into everything.
Yep. So, well, you know what, man? While we're raging, we may as well rage the right way. And let's dive into some community thoughts. Now, this week, guys, there's somebody else who's not happy about the Rogue class. That is for certain. And this person's name is Hello. So, without further ado. Hello says, Rogues are dead, R.I.P. First try, Blizzard, for ruining the once beautiful game of Hearthstone. You did not nerf mages and stupid brainless rushdown decks, but oh wow, you nerfed a already nerfed class. Yes, Patient Assassin, Kidnapper, make a new expansion and nerf Auctioneer. I can't believe. Now tell me, what other deck should I play since Rogue are dead? Why, probably Pirates. There's nothing else anyways. So yeah, whoopsies. So.
I think our Pirates deck was better.
As a matter of fact, personally, I kind of think that, like if we were going to make a Rogue deck that was a little bit better, I think we probably, we could probably do this. And then we do that, and then we do that. And dude, there you go. I think we're pretty much sitting on a better Rogue deck right there. So
explosive Iron Sensei into explosive sheep, guys. Yeah. That's the new meta.
And an Undertaker. Why the heck not?
Light Warden. Definitely Light Warden.
Oh, yeah.
So much heal.
Flying Machine. Oh, God. It's Thralmar Farseer. Sabotage. I think that could have a home in this deck. Cult Master. Ogre Ninja. It did throw Trade Prince in there, thank God. And Mally.
I think Ogre Ninja actually could be good, to be honest.
Do you really?
It's, what is it, 6/6 for 5?
Ogre
and
Ninja.
And it has stealth, so you can't deal with it.
50% chance to attack the wrong enemy.
I kind of want to make an ogre rogue and kind of like go along with that. I think the ogres are underutilized right now.
Because I think they can single-handedly lose you games as well.
Well, you run them with a 3/5 that dispels your entire hand or your entire board.
I'm
going to do it, guys. I'm going to make it. I'm going to get legend with it. And by that, I mean I'm going to do neither of those things.
and by make it and get legend, I mean it's not going to happen at all. So, you know, I'm so put out by this deck, I'm almost considering not uploading it. But people will kill me if I don't, so I need to.
No, we're playing. They can make fun of us for being salty and stuff. They can be
no,
like,
that's
oh,
fine.
Good.
Yeah, and we'll get it, too. We'll get it.
We deserve it. No, for this, we deserve it. We deserve it, guys.
Look at that look on his face. We deserve it, guys. Man. We deserve it.
Let me tell you the day I had. Let me just tell you the day I had. Actually, I don't even need to tell you the day I had. I need to tell you the first 5 minutes of work I had. You guys ready for this?
First five.
I go to work. I see an email. It goes, our tester, which we're the stuff we test our all our sensors with, is its screen is showing whatever it shows when it's like no video available or
de pinche de no es bueno. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, no, so that's the email I see, and guess what the problem was?
I don't know.
All right, well, I'm going to give you two guesses. The most logical reason why there's no video.
Should I kill that?
And then, no. And then the second most logical reason why there's no video.
It's not plugged in.
Yes, correct. You got a first try. First try. Wasn't plugged in.
I don't mean
unbelievable. What is the first thing you check?
To make sure that it's plugged in. Make sure there's power going to the... Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes, sir.
I kind of like Blood Mage Delnosing and backstabbing that.
Yeah.
Oh, I was definitely salty at work. I'll tell you, I was pissed. Like, how are you an engineer and you don't think initially,
do we have power going to this?
Yeah, it wasn't even power. The connection, like, the monitor cable is just loose.
I'm just going to hit
his face. I kind of like just hitting face and re-diggering.
See, this is when I want to draw, like, trade prints next turn.
Mm-hmm.
Because the board's not going to be out of control. Oh, man. Ysera? You going to Ysera me? Freak. Sap, please. Selling my soul for a sap.
It's your Drake. I think you just backstab it.
Why?
Mainly because I want to get the 3 damage on it before it's damaged. Because it's going to run into your Archer Drake.
Should we get another 2 on it? Prep Fan of Knives?
I kind of want to, just to see if we can freaking draw sap. We're going to draw sap right now.
Yeah.
And I kind of like just hitting it once with the dagger.
No. I kind of don't.
We're going to do it.
I hate you, Stutter.
Why not?
Because that's 4 damage. Let's say he just...
We have to hit it anyways, and then we can sell C deckhands after this. Unbelievable, man.
No, totally believable. That's 4 extra damage we didn't need to take.
Not we had to take it. We had to take that damage, Twiz. Lothab. End turn. I hate Ysera. This is the one time Ysera's ever worked out for him, by the way, guys.
Yeah.
Hit the... Yep. Shiv the 1-2. Yep. Oh, crap, this isn't gonna work out. Oh, we're dead. No, wait, we can play Flurry right now. No, we can't. Alright, we're dead. But it doesn't matter. Played Flurry. Earthwing Farseer, your face. I don't think it mattered what we did here, Twiz. Yeah. I think we were going to pretty much lose this game no matter what.
Yep.
I don't know why he's thinking hard. He can play any card in the entire game right now, and he will win this game.
Yeah.
Any card
like,
at all.
Say...
He could pick 7 Angry Chickens.
Novice Engineer. He could play that and win. That's why I always keep a sap in the opening hand against a druid, or I actually try and mulligan for a sap, because I've had this happen to me more than once. You did this to me. Remember when you did this to me? It was like turn 4, Ysera. That's exactly what happened. Double innervate coin Ysera. And here's Twiz. Can't do a damn thing about it. Oh, there's another thing. Let me see if I have this or not. Oh, I don't. Please tell me you're AFK.
If he DCs, we win.
I doubt.
He probably is lethal. He's just dicking around with us.
Okay. We'll take it. He still gets a card. You shouldn't get a card for that. Just me, though.
I would... Shinvenor. SI7, the 4-5 Usera that we can't ever deal with. Yeah.
That we finally, on turn 8, been able to deal with, yes.
Yep.
And then clear it with that.
Yep. And just play one of those. Play SLC deck, and we need to just go.
Yeah, he's going to be back at his keyboard any second now.
I know.
And we got to hurry up.
Go, please be a long poop. Please be a long poop.
Oh, my God. You know what? Maybe it's the new office that's bad luck.
Yeah, we're changing it back right now. I'm going to fly down there. We're changing it. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, Mrs. Twiz.
Can't have it.
You brought upon Snuggles, and now you're changing it. Please, your drink.
Yeah.
Dagger up. Yep, Celsius deckhand, go face with everything. And end turn as quickly as possible. Yeah, I'm putting this on. Yep, in your face.
That's right. We are outplaying.
He's gonna kill us right now.
We are outplaying the hell.
Oh my god! Can he even kill us? He can't kill us.
Force roar is unless he innervates another. No, he doesn't even have enough mana. He can't even innervate out another roar. Oh, he doesn't have innervate. Yeah, we fought the Ysera battle.
He can innervate out the hero power, but he doesn't have it.
He double innervated coin.
Yeah, no, I know. I'm just saying.
Yeah. I'm going to wait for him to come back and concede. Ladies and gentlemen, all right. It finally worked out. I found the strategy to this deck. Your opponent has to be AFK for you to win. That is the magic of how this deck works.
Oh, my God.
That is the magic. So... Yeah.
Yeah, he thought we were. He played the Ysera, and then he thought we would concede, so he just sat there.
Oh my god. Anyways. Oh gosh. Well,
that is Dex OP.
Dude, it's something. So, you know what? Here, stutter real quick while I'm bringing up iTunes. I forgot to check if we have. Give the deck breakdown of or give the quick whatever you call it. I don't even if you guys want to know a deck not to use, pay attention to the next 45 seconds.
All right, so we got two Celsi deckhands for combos with Tink Master Oil, Wood Oil, Tink Master Sharp Wood Oil. I'm never gonna get the name of that card right. We got NTK Bot for heals. I'm just gonna go over the cards that you're not normally seeing in.
Yeah, all the cards that we need that we never draw.
Go ahead. Yeah, highlight those. You got Trade Prince Galliwink, his swag. He's the only good card in this deck. You got Sprint for card draw. You got Lotheb because Lotheb is awesome. You got Azure Drakes because Azure Drakes is awesome. The problem with this deck is like 4 on is pretty solid.
Yeah.
Excuse me. But everything else kind of is like, ugh. You know, SI7s are still really good in this meta, but... then we got Nurthering First here for heal. Yep. Probably need more of those, like 10, maybe 20.
Good solid 6 or 7.
Knives. We got a Bloodmage Thalnos because we need the card draw, and he's an okay turn 2 play.
Yeah.
We got one Shiv because Shiv is really good. Sometimes, I guess, sort of, not
we
really.
We got one Shiv because, well, Shiv is really good.
Yeah, we only play one. We don't really play Shiv. I don't know. Shiv's just kind of like a filler card. It's like, oh, let's just cycle.
Yeah. Well, it's because it works in conjunction. It's cheap enough that it can work in conjunction on turn 4 or turn 7 for an extra 1 damage. So.
Yeah. But honestly, I don't know. I don't know about this deck.
Yeah. You know, it looked good on paper. It really did.
Mm-hmm.
It really did. So, sorry if this was a little...
That last game made up for the entire episode.
It absolutely did. It took us the entire episode to figure out how to win with this deck. That's what kills me. The entire thing. So, with that, ladies and gentlemen, we don't have any iTunes reviews, but we are available on iTunes, and the Heroes Power Hour is available on iTunes. And that's featured tomorrow night. Again, if you're just joining this now, the Heroes Power Hour is Tuesday night, twitch.tv/twizcast, 9 p.m. Central Standard Time, 10 Eastern, 7 Pacific. We're giving away 20 Heroes of the Storm beta keys that you can jump into the Nexus and roll with us. Good times, and I'm going to talk a little bit more about that on tomorrow night's show, the whole beta invite thing and how some people in the community need to get hit in the head with a tack hammer, but that's just me. Anyways, we hope to catch you guys there. Really, really appreciate you guys tuning in. Stutter, is there anything you want to say before we blast out?
Yeah, excuse my language in chat.
Okay.
All right.
Well,
I said I wishing I could spell, but at least I could plug in a bleep computer monitor.
Oh, hey, there is one more thing that I want you guys to check out and be a part of, all right? Extralife.blizzpro.com. Okay, BlizzPro is putting together a team, okay? Like, you sign up under the BlizzPro name, and you are a team member for this event, and you pledge to do 24 hours of gaming. It doesn't have to be streamed, but you do 24 hours of gaming, okay? And BlizzPro wants to raise $10,000 for Extra Life charities. I mean, you're helping sick kids in a hospital. So here's what you can do. Extralife.blizzpro.com, and you can sign up, be part of the team, help BlizzPro raise $10,000, get your gaming on, get people to donate to you while you're gaming, whether it's streamed or however it is that you're going to do it. A lot of people do it all kind of around the same time, but you can do it any time during the year that you want. But be a part of it. And you know, we're more than happy to help push you guys, you know, push your stream if you're doing that. However, you know, however we got to help you, this is a good cause. There's no reason not to. So make sure you guys are checking that out. Get with @ReviewDadMedia, R-E-V-I-E-W Dad Media on Twitter. He is the team captain. Get with him for details if you want. Or you can email us podcast@blizzpro.com, and we can go from there. So make sure you guys are doing that. There's no reason in the world not to. All right, Stutter, is that going to work for you? Is there anything else?
Works great.
All right.
You know, play video games for kids. How often can you say, I want to play video games for charity, guys? Yeah. Just do it.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So, all right, guys, we are going to be, thank you all for your emails and stuff like that. We've gotten a lot of emails from people with deck lists and stuff like that. We're still going through it. It's a lot to cipher and figure out and stuff like that. But, we're going to be back next week with a deck that hopefully doesn't suck as bad as this one. So, love you all more than life itself. Take care. Thank you for what you do. See ya.